Like, we have the drunk coffee, Limoncillo, Nicaragua, brewed with coffee roasted by drunk coffee roasters.
Yeah, you could just call it the drunk coffee.
TamamuraHonten.co.jp.
Welcome to Akihabeera, where in 2016 the Japanese beer industry has resolved that it will no longer go commando on trampoline day. I'm Eric.
I'm Casey. Today we're inciting underage drinking with the Tamamura Honten drunk coffee.
I don't remember where I got this. I picked this up a couple months ago. It's been sitting in my fridge for a while. I got it at Liquors Hasegawa.
Yes!
In Tokyo Station, our favorite beer joint. It comes to us from, as Casey said, Tamamura Honten. They are the makers of the Shigo Kogen beer, although this does not say Shigo Kogen on the label, so I don't think we can call it that.
So that's kind of a point of confusion, I guess. I always thought Shigo Kogen was the brewery.
Right.
So... do you have any clarification on that?
Nope.
Fantastic.
I think we can safely call it Tamamura Honten.
Okay.
As the brewery. As you can tell from the name, this is a coffee beer. It's a collaboration between Tamamura Honten and Trunk Coffee in Nagoya. And hence the name is Drunk Coffee.
Oh.
It also says on the label, you pointed it out, it says Limoncillo, Nicaragua. Limoncillo,
which is a type of alcohol, right?
No, that's what I thought.
Okay.
That's the type of coffee bean. I think the alcohol is limoncello.
It smells extremely hoppy.
Yeah, so I don't want to ruin anything, but...
there's hops in it.
There are hops in it. It does say on the blog that I read that this does have about the same amount of hops in it as their IPA does.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Do you think anything strange about this beer?
It doesn't have a coffee color in the slightest.
Right. So normally beers that have coffee in them are like stouts.
Yeah.
Or porters or something beers. Because they use roasted malt to go along with the flavor of the roasted coffee beans. So this is unusual for a coffee beer.
Yeah. I was kind of confused at first. One, from the smell.
Mm-hmm.
And two, from the appearance. Like, nothing about this says coffee to me.
Right.
I'm going to start putting hops in my coffee.
All right. So should we take a drink of this?
Yes.
Okay. So this is the Tamamura Honten and Trunk Coffee Drunk Coffee.
Very strong flavor.
Very strong coffee flavor.
Yeah.
Very, very like that coffee acidity.
Yeah, it's a bit different from coffee. Like, it doesn't taste like black coffee necessarily, but it does taste like a roasted coffee type drink. I don't know how to explain the difference, but it doesn't taste like black coffee to me.
The flavor profile of these limoncillo coffee beans is like tropical fruity.
That might be it then.
Yeah,
maybe it's so, just the type of bean.
The story on the blog that I read was that the brewmaster went to this coffee shop in Nagoya, had a cup of this coffee, and was like, holy shit, we got to make this into a beer.
So I like this.
How this came about.
Yeah. I'm not sure if you were able to see in the pour, but not a lot of head.
Mm-hmm.
Though it does seem like there's a decent bit of carbonation.
It's bubbly.
Yeah.
It is a modest 32 IBUs, which is... unusual. I thought unusual considering that they use the same amount of hops as in the IPA.
Yeah.
It just turned out to be not quite as bitter. But it's a hoppy.
That's also kind of, it's surprising it's so low because it seems really hoppy. It seems to me like you can never know without talking to the guy who made it. But drinking something like this, it almost comes, the flavor comes across as accomplishing exactly what he set out to accomplish.
Probably.
Because it doesn't seem like you can accidentally stumble upon this type of flavor. Like, he knew what he was going for and he did it.
I think it was a great idea to not use roasted malt.
Yeah,
in this case, because
it really changes what would you say? It really changes the constitution of the beer.
The interplay of the hops and the coffee.
Entirely different flavors come out from that.
I think when you use coffee beans and roasted malt, you end up just they blend together.
Yeah.
And so you're not sure what you're tasting anymore. With this, you're getting like this kind of golden ale hoppy flavor, and then just kind of washed over with this strong fruity coffee.
Yeah. Which, like, not to say that dark coffee beers aren't good.
No,
they're awesome.
Yeah,
but yeah, this is something entirely different that I can't say I've had before. I can't think of the topping, but it reminds me of a certain topping on pizza.
Interesting.
Like a Pizza Hut roasted something. think of pizza and Pizza Hut while taking a drink of that.
All right. I see what you mean.
Yeah, but what is that? There's something about it. Am I crazy?
No, you're not crazy.
Okay.
This is going to end up in my probably top five beers we've done on the show so far.
I'm really impressed with everything this beer is.
Yeah. Goes down smooth because it's really light, but it's got this meaty roasted flavor to it.
Yeah, yeah.
But it has the hop profile and it has the fruity coffee, the fruit from the coffee.
Can you think of any food or otsumami pairing?
That's what I'm trying to think of. Yeah, Pizza Hut.
Pizza.
I can't stop thinking about Pizza Hut now when I drink it.
Yeah,
you like ruined me. It's the FedEx arrow.
Inception.
If you get a chance to find this, buy it immediately. Buy all of the inventory they have, and then send two bottles to...
to this address.
The address below.
Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Check out our Twitter.
Yeah.
Yeah. You can also ring in the new year with us with the Kagawa Rouge and Kagawa Blanc that we drank last week, which you can find down in the lower corner here.
Great job, Tamamura Honten, and for the rest of you, find this.